Andy Warhol was my first boss. He gave me my big break to be a journalist when I was a grad student at Columbia University. And he hired me and my friend Bob Policello to run Interview Magazine, which we did for several years in our youth. And we're both still doing magazine stuff. Well, for me, Andy Warhol was like a great professor that you never had. He was sort of like a really weird dad, and he was also like a really good teacher. And he taught in a really smart way because he never lectured you. He kind of knew how to get you to do what he wanted to do by sort of flattering you in the right direction. I think I learned more about business from him than from anybody. He was one of the great business and work geniuses of his time. You know, I worked for Rolling Stone, I worked for Playboy, I was a stand-up comic. I accidentally had a career in advertising. I became creative director of advertising for Barney's New York, Calvin Klein, Island Records, and I still do. I have this kind of schizophrenic life where I do a lot of sort of artistic commercial stuff and writing. And I also have sort of 1 foot or 3 toes in the art world. This is about my 6th book. Although if you like look on Amazon, I probably have like 50 books, but this is like about my 6th like real full-on book. It's a philosophy book disguised as a humor book, disguised as an advice book. And I called it How to Be a Man because I thought it would make women want to buy it and to see if men had any secrets that they didn't know about or they would think it might improve their boyfriend. The 2 secrets of How to Be a Man are never lie unless it's for world peace and always dress like you're going somewhere better later.